A very good morning to you all. Now that we have understood the basic skill of direct laryngoscopy, I'll move on to the next topic, that is supraglottic airway devices. Supraglottic airway devices, they fill a niche between the face mask and the tracheal tube in terms of both the anatomical position and the degree of invasiveness. It is known that the tracheal intubation is the gold standard method, but it has its own set of complications, like it causes a stress response, causes more sore throat, and the other complications. So this is basically a minimally invasive devices which keep the upper airway clear for unobstructed ventilation, and they afford effective assisted ventilation without requiring endotracheal intubation or visualization of the glottis. This is a classification of the supraglottic airway devices, which is very elaborate. It depends upon whether the device is cuffed or cuffless. The classic LMA is the benchmark for the first generation of the LMA devices, and it was introduced in 1989, after which there has been an explosion of supraglottic airway devices, which are routinely being continuously introduced into the market, which are claimed to be superior or even better than the classic LMA. For the purpose of this presentation, I'll be discussing only the common laryngeal mask airways, which we routinely use, and not to get confused with a wide array of supraglottic devices. Next, a more simpler classification given by Cook et al. It divides the supraglottic airway devices into first generation and the second generation devices. The first generation devices are simple airway tubes that keep the upper airway patent and help in assisted ventilation. The second generation devices, they incorporate extensive design features which have an extended drain tube, gastric drain tube, which helps in the gastric, which prevents the gastric aspiration and the encephalation and deflates the gastric stoma. So the first generation incorporates the classic LMA, the flexible LMA, intubating LMA, ambu laryngeal mask, laryngeal tube, and the cobra perilaryngeal airway. The second generation, all these incorporate a gastric drain tube. These are Procil LMA, Supreme LMA, iGel, laryngeal tube suction, streamlined liner of the pharynx airway. So what are the advantages of LMA? The primary advantages are that the ease of insertion. The tracheal intubation requires certain amount of skill. However, with video laryngoscopy, that amount of skill is lessened. But still, the tracheal intubation requires some amount of skill. Even a novice physician can insert the supraglottic airway and retain the skill even after that. Neuromuscular blockade is not required for the insertion. However, obtundation of the airway reflexes is very important. It avoids the complications of intubation, as already discussed. A very important thing is that it can be used either alone as a primary airway device or as an aid to endotracheal intubation. Definitely the stress response is lessened, so the patient has a very smooth awakening, and it can be also used as a bridge to extubation. This is a picture showing the classic LMA, which is a benchmark for all the laryngeal mask airways. The different parts are the inflatable cuff, the aperture bars, the airway tube, a standard 15mm connector, the inflation line, inflation pilot balloon, and a metallic valve. It is made up of silicon and is reusable. The manufacturer recommends around 40 times usage, but it is said that it can be used over 100 times if properly autoclaved and maintained. The main disadvantage of classic LMA is that it has a low pharyngeal pressure seal of only around 20 centimeter water, which increases the risk of aspiration. If we see the anatomy of how the LMA is placed inside, we see when properly placed, the mask rests on the hypopharyngeal floor. The sides face the piriform fossae, and the upper border of the cuff is behind the tongue base. The epiglottis tip may rest either within the mask bowl or under the proximal cuff. So basically, whenever the LMA is placed, we have two types of seals. First is the pharyngeal seal, which seals the glottis, so there is no leakage of air or the spill into the larynx. The other is the esophageal seal, which minimizes the gastric encephalation. The LMA sits in the esophagus and closes it off, allowing ventilations only through the larynx. LMA unique. It's a disposable version of a classic LMA. It's single-use, disposable, made up of polyvinyl chloride, and definitely it costs less. There are 7 sizes. Dimensions are identical to the classic LMA. The tube is stiffer, and the cuff is less compliant. Another LMA, the LMA Flexible, it has a wire reinforced tube that is longer and narrower. But it is more difficult to insert than a classic LMA, and it requires a stillet for insertion. There are 6 sizes, sizes 2 to 6, and a disposable version of flexible LMA is also available. The disadvantages are the patient may bite, and it can cause the airway obstruction because of the kinking of the flexible wire. Because of the metallic wire may get kinked. The smaller tube diameter, because of this presence of the reinforcement, it may limit the insertion of the endoscope and the tracheal tube size that can be passed through it. And it is definitely unsuitable for usage in MRI unit. The ProSeal LMA, another a very versatile LMA, which is considered a benchmark for all the second generation LMAs. It has a reinforced airway tube, an additional dorsal cuff, which is not here in the picture, an esophageal drain tube, and a cuff, introducer strap, a manual vent, inflation pilot balloon, and a very important integral bite block. The sealing pressure is higher, the pharyngeal sealing pressure is higher than that of a classical LMA, and it is about 30 centimeter of water. It comes in 6 sizes from 1.5 to 5. The ProSeal LMA is less suitable as an intubation device. LMA Supreme, it is a disposable version of the ProSeal LMA. It is recommended for single use. It is made up of PVC, has a built-in drain tube. You can see this is a gastric drain tube. It has the features integrated of a ProSeal LMA, intubating LMA, and a LMA unique. Another recent and an important LMA fast track. It has a short, it consists of 3 things, the intubating LMA itself, an introducer, and a special endotracheal tube which is made up of silicone and has a tapered end and a smaller cuff. It has a short curved stainless steel shaft which we hold and insert. It's more easy to insert, but because of its rigidity when placed, it may get dislodged more easier than the classic LMA. It's available only in 3 adult sizes, 3, 4, and 5. Disposable versions are also available. It has a more incidence of sore throat because of the more bulk and the more cuff pressure. It may be used as a primary airway device or as an unanticipated difficult airway. It's easier to insert, but as I already said, there are more chances of dislodgement with the movement of the head and the neck. Novice physicians have more success in inserting it for the first time. And the fiber optic intubation is also possible through this. Another is a streamlined liner of the pharynx nerve. It also belongs to the first generation of the LMAs. It is a plastic disposable uncuffed device, which is anatomical shaped to line the pharynx. It has 3 parts, the toe, the bridge, and the stem. It forms a seal with the pharynx at the base of the tongue and the entrance to the esophagus. 6 adult sizes that relate to the dimension across the bridge. This is the bridge, and the 6 adult sizes that relate to the dimension across the bridge are available. The disadvantages is that the choice of appropriate size is difficult. iGel. iGel belongs to the second generation of the LMA. It is made up of a gel-like transparent thermoplastic elastomer which seals without an inflatable cuff. So less chances of pressure complications. It has an integral bite block marked with a black line that signifies the optimum incisor teeth position. It has a gastric channel. 3 small sizes are available. The smallest one is the yellow one, the medium is the green one, and the largest is the red one. These are the disposable and are single-use devices. There are various other variants such as Cobra PLA, the ARQ, and the C-track. The intubation through the LM is basically a blind procedure. So the incorporation of the fiber optics along with the LMA has led to the invention of this device, the C-track, in which the LMA is inserted, and then this video camera is attached, screen is attached, through which we can see the intubation. So for the insertion of the LMA, first of all, we have to select the appropriate size we have to make the right choice which device is required appropriate for our patients. Pre-use inspection is very important. See for any cuff leaks, for any kinking of the wire, and for the patency of the airway tube. We deflate the LMA device, we lubricate it, position the patient. After the correct insertion, we inflate and check for the any leak. This is the procedure. This is the picture showing the procedure of the insertion of the LMA. After the cuff deflation and the lubrication and the pre-use inspection, we position the patient, stabilize the occiput, hold the LMA in a pen-like fashion with a middle finger between the between the mask and the airway tube, and glide it along the heart palate, pressing it with the index finger. This I shall demonstrate in the next session. So the uses of supraglottic airway devices are many, and the few ones are, these can be used for patients undergoing a short elective minor surgeries. For out of hospital by less experienced users, such as those patients, for non-anesthesiologist physicians can also secure the airway in these patients. During CPR, it can be used, and very important, difficult airway management. This is a difficult airway algorithm where LMA can be used as a primary airway device or as a rescue device or as an aid for fiber optic intubation. The complications are malplacement in around 0 to 41%. It can be dislodged with the movements of the head and the neck. Sore throat, the incidence varies from 0 to 70%, and more it is maximum with the C fast track. Compression injuries to the pharyngeal nerves, lingual, hypoglossal, and the recurrent laryngeal nerve have also been reported. Gastric distension may occur with the first generation LMAs, and the risk of aspiration is around 2.3 to 10.2 per 10,000 cases in adults. The incidence is lowest with the LMA ProSeal. The contraindications of the LMA should be known to everyone. It is contraindicated in those patients who have very high pressures, airway pressures. In those patients who have increased risk of aspiration, such as GE reflux, hiatus hernia, trauma, intoxication, or the airway injuries. Patients with the tracheomalacia or the external tracheal compression, such as the infraglottic airway obstruction, in those cases it is not recommended. Supraglottic pathologies such as cyst, abscess, hematoma, and tissue disruption also contraindicate the use of LMAs. Major cervical pathologies such as large goiter, swelling in the hypopharynx, neck fibrosis, laryngeal cancer, or a deviated trachea are also contraindications. It's relatively contraindicated in situations in which there is restricted access to the airway. Other absolute contraindications are where the mouth opening is limited or the complete airway obstruction is there. So the take-home message is, supraglottic airway devices can be used as a primary airway device or rescue devices or as a conduit for fiber optic intubation. They are not to be considered as a substitute for tracheal intubation, especially in those emergency situations where the patient has full stomach or other contraindications of usage of LMA. And the supraglottic devices having a gastric drain tube, it should be considered as a standard of care. This presentation, my aim was to just to make you knowledgeable of the different types of the airway devices available, the demonstration for the insertion and the fiber optic intubation or the normal intubation through it shall be demonstrated in the next session. Thank you.